Hi all, subscribe to our channel on YouTube and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. For course inquiries, visit our website www.gatelectures.com and don't forget to register and subscribe to the latest post section.
Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Now in this video, we'll start our discussion with the data link layer. As I told you in the introduction video, that we'll be discussing about all the layers one by one. And here, we'll start with data link layer, and we'll start with the delays that we face in case of computer networks. Now, I'll try to make this as simple as possible so that you'll be able to start and understand this thing very easily. Now, let us say what are the various delays that we are going to discuss. We'll discuss about the transmission delay. Then we'll discuss about the propagation delay. Then there's something called as queuing delay. Then there's something called as processing delay, etc. So in this first three or four videos, we'll be discussing about these delays one by one. And with these delays, we are also going to discuss about the previous year questions that are asked in GATE as well as the UGC NET examinations, and also take videos from questions from other examinations. Now we'll start with the transmission delay and what is the transmission delay. And there's some basic terminologies that is required and the basic information that is required. So I'm going to take those informations one by one within this video. Now what is the transmission delay? Assuming that this is the sender, and this is the receiver. We have sender and the receiver. Now, sender produces some data packet which it wants to send to the receiver, assuming that these are the data packets. This is the data packet. And the size of the data packet can be anything. Right, so we'll discuss about the size of the data packet, obviously, in case of transmission delay. Now, the time taken to put all these data packet from here to this transmission line, or you can say the transmission media, that is called as a transmission delay. Okay, so this is called as a transmission media. Transmission media, or you can say transmission line. Now this transmission media can be anything. It can be wire transmission media, it can be wireless transmission media, because the only aim or only work of the transmission media is to transfer some bits of information from here, from this side to that particular side. Now the time taken to place all this data packet from the sender, or you can say the host, to this transmission media is called as a transmission time. This is called as transmission time. Transmission time, or you can say TT. We have transmission time, or you can say TT. Now when I'm saying this transmission time, on what factors this transmission time is dependent on? So you can say this transmission time is directly dependent on the size of the data packet. Size of the data packet. That means if the size of the data packet is more, then the transmission time will be more. If the size of the data packet is less or small, then the transmission time is small. And this transmission time is inversely proportional to the bandwidth of the network. Bandwidth of the network. That means if you have a greater bandwidth or if you have big bandwidth, then the transmission time will be less. So by the help of these two things, we can say that transmission time can also be found out as transmission time is equal to size of data packet, or sometimes it is also called as the length of data packet divided by what is the bandwidth that we are discussing. Now, just for a simple example, let us say that the size of the data packet, or you can say the length of the packet, is around 1 kilobyte, 1 KB. See, make sure I'm using capital B here, I'm not using small b, because if I'm using capital B, that means I'm discussing about byte, but if I'm using small b, that means I'm discussing about bit. And let us say the bandwidth of the network is 1 kilo KBPS, or you can say 1 kilobits per second. Make sure that here I'm using kilobits. It is small b, that means it is a bits, right? Now you need to find what is the transmission time in this particular case. Now, when I'm saying the length of the data packet is 1 kilobyte, that means it can be written as 2 raised to power 10 bytes, or it can be written as 2 raised to power 13 bits. Why? Because 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. So if you convert this 2 raised to power 10 bytes to bits, then it will be 2 raised to power 13 bits. And here, where I'm saying bandwidth is equal to 1 KBPS, or 1 kilobits per second. Now there's a huge difference between how we calculate this kilo here and how we calculate this kilo in case of size of the data packet. Generally, this bandwidth is measured in the powers of 10. And the size of the data packet is measured in the powers of 2. Why? Because this bandwidth, or when data is traveling through this media, this bandwidth is generally measured in terms of frequencies, and this is measured in terms of bits. So that is why the size is measured in the powers of 2, and this is the size is measured in the powers of 10. Or you can say, when I'm saying 1 kilobits per second, that means it can be written as 10 raised to power 3 bits per second. 10 raised to power 3 bits per second is the bandwidth of the network. 10 raised to power 3. Correct? So if I find out what is the transmission time that will be required to transfer this data, then that will be equal to the length of the data packet upon the bandwidth of the network, where the length of the data packet is 2 raised to power 13 bits upon the bandwidth of the network is 10 raised to power 3 bits per second. Now you see here we have bits per second. So because it is bits per second, or you can say, when I'm saying bits per second, or you can, when I say 10 raised to power 3 bits per second, it means it is 10 raised to power 3 bits divided by 1 second. Or you can say, in 1 second, there are 10 raised to power 3 bits that we are transferring in the network. Now, when I'm saying it is 2 raised to power 13 bits per bits, that means it can also be written as 2 raised to power 10 multiplied by 2 raised to power 3, which is again equivalent to 1024 multiplied by 8. And when I'm saying 10 raised to power 3 bits per second, so this per second in this case will go in the numerator, and these bits and bits will get cancelled. Therefore, we are going to get the time in terms of seconds. So it will be this divided by 1000, or you can say 10 raised to power 3, or you can say this divided by 10 raised to power 3. Now for this particular case, if you have 1024 multiplied by 8, then how much you are going to get? This is 2, this is 3, 16, and this is 9, and this is 1, again 1, and this is 8. So it will be 8192 divided by 1000 seconds, or you can say it is 8.192 seconds. Therefore, for this particular case, when we have bandwidth is 1 kbps and the length of the data packet is 1 kilobyte, for this particular case, if you want to if you want to give a transmission time for this, then the transmission time will be equivalent to 8.192 seconds. Okay, so most of the time students make mistakes in this particular case. Why? Because they assume that if the length of the data packet is also 2 raised to power 10, then here also K1 KB is equal to 2 raised to power 10. Just for a very, very classical case here, let us say if I give you the length of data packet in terms of bits. Okay, generally bandwidth is always given in terms of bits, right? In sometimes, for example, you say that at your home you are having 2 Mbps connection. 2 Mbps means it is 2 megabits per second. Megabits, it is not megabytes. So generally, whenever your internet service provider is giving you plans, always make sure it is megabits per second. You can always find it out easily. Okay. Now, if I say the length of the data packet is 1 kilobits. And if the bandwidth of the network is again 1 kilobits per second, then you can find it out. It is 2 raised to power 10 bits, and this can also be written as 10 raised to power 3 bits per second. Or if I say the transmission time, then that will be equal to 2 raised to power 10 divided by 10 raised to power 3, which is 1024 divided by 1000, or you can say it is 1.024 seconds. Okay, so there's a huge difference in saying this and this, right? In saying bandwidth, or you can say the length of the data packets. Okay, so this is how you can find the transmission time in case of a network. Now we know what is the transmission time. In the next video, we'll be discussing about what is the propagation delay, what is the transmission delay, and what is the propagation delay. Okay.